Welcome back. This is the report section of the Cash Book Manager, and this helps us to generate reports of all the activities that have been going on in the cash transaction section and the setup we have on the business setting. The user just have limited inputs here, which he needs to make or she needs to make in this orange cells, and the report automatically generates as we have the start date, the bank code and the transaction type. So when you select your criteria, the report is generated based on this criteria you've selected. Right. So you can see we have our bank, your company name in here and the report title. And these two cells are also automated. So please, though it's not colored blue, but I want to mention here that you are not to tamper with these two cells so that you will not, these two sections, so that you won't alter the formulas. So whatever we select here is reflected in the report heading, and the date also is affected on the each of the column heading, because each of the column heading represents each monthly report, right, up to the 12th month. So let's say I want to generate from the month of May. Let me see, okay, from January, February, right? Immediately you see it starts from February here, and the report will say from February 2020 to January 2021 for all transaction on BK02. So let's say we select withdrawals here. You see it will say for withdrawals transaction, and let's say I select bank 01. You see for bank 01 details, right? So we'll just take it back to, because we don't have much transaction in there, we'll just take it back to bank 02. So that's how you select your criteria to generate report based on the criteria selected. So the user is just limited to inputs criteria of the report he or she wants to generate on this orange cells. And again, in this section where we have the account number, the user can select account number, and it comes in place where the user introduces a new account number, and it has to be done in the business setting section at our chart of accounts section, where you introduce a new account number. Immediately you introduce that new account number and transaction has taken place in that account, you come to your reports, the cash report section, and insert a new cell in order to capture that new account. And to insert that cell, you select this last cell, the sales task control, to insert it. That new account number needs to come before it. So our sales task control should not have any accounts below it. So the new cell, the new account we've introduced should come before it. So that's why you will just select, right click, and insert. So immediately it comes before the sales task control. So you select the account, and immediately this account name select, then you now fill, right? You fill. So let's say we select, just that the account we are selecting here needs to be unique. If you select an account code twice, it will pop up a red cell telling you, showing that account is appearing two times, because in this report it has to be unique codes. Each account will appear once, but let's say it's 5,000 we introduce newly. But because 5,000 has already been captured here, you see immediately the cell is colored red to tell you that this account is appearing twice, right? So all I need to do now is to fill this, because there are formula here. So I'll fill it down, right? You see, I'll fill it down. Then I will drag the formula. So you fill with the formula above, not the one below. So the formula above the new cell, so you just fill it down. The sales control formula is quite different from others. That's why the new cell should be captured before the sales control account. So here is the total, you just drag and fill, right? So that's what you need to do to introduce a new account code in your cash book report. I believe that's all you need to know and you need to get concerning this section of the cash book manager, right? And if you have any question while using it, please don't hesitate. to send those questions, and I'll be glad to help you. Thanks for staying on. I'll be going into the bank reconciliation section in the next video guide.